And for today, our pilot is Professor Surbhi Arora. And the co-pilot for today is Nancy. And other few members for today is Rashleen, Bhavna. Okay, everyone is ready to fly to Canada?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Great. So over to you, ma'am. Nancy and Professor Surbhi.
Yeah, thank you, Shruti. Thank you so much. It's very heartening to see so many enthusiasts, looking forward to the trip to Canada. And a lot of them have a lot of knowledge they have found from various sources. And I'm glad that they're so well aware about Canada. So children, are you ready to go with us on the trip to Canada, virtual trip?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am. Yes. This is my Canada keychain with the Canada coin. I'm glad.
That's nice. That's very nice.
Ma'am, my father is a travel manager, so he has 200 planes and he is here in Canada also. I can see both.
That's great.
Yeah.
And I'm wearing a t-shirt of Canada also.
That's nice. Show it. Just stand up so that it is visible to every one of us. Oh, wow. That's nice. What is written on this?
Air Canada.
Okay, great. Nice.
Air Canada is National Airline of Canada.
Yes, yes.
And Canada's national symbol is maple leaf.
Yes. And their favorite...
Canada's currency.
Yeah.
Canada's currency is Canadian dollar.
Yes. And Canada flag has a maple leaf on that flag. And maple syrup is their favorite. Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you know they put maple syrup on the snow and then eat it as a snack? Do you know that?
Ma'am, I didn't know that.
Ma'am, I know that.
I am hearing this.
Yes, ma'am, I know.
Yeah. When it is snowing outside, they just put some maple syrup on the snow and just eat it as a snack.
They make it as a snowball and then put some syrup.
Yes.
And then they
Yes. So maple leaf and maple syrup are their favorite.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Flag,
very good afternoon.
Ma'am, on Canadian flag, that maple, that maple leaf represents?
Maple leaf represents, I think it's a leaf which is there on that tree. And all across Canada, you find that kind of, autumn types of this thing, and I'm not too sure of why there's this maple leaf, but I think it represents this autumn season, because in Canada you can experience all the four seasons in one day. It happened last in 1962.
Ma'am, I can't hear your voice clearly, ma'am. It is a bit breaking.
Okay. I'll repeat again. In 1962, there was a day when the people of Canada near Alberta witnessed all the four seasons in a single day. So they joke also around that they can experience four seasons in 24 hours. So the temperature could vary between minus 19 degrees. I think maybe it's the internet. So the temperature may vary between minus 19 to plus 22 degrees in a single day. So that's why people joke about it, that they can experience all the four seasons in a single day.
Okay.
Nancy, can we start with the presentation?
Yes, ma'am, sure.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
So children, we'll... just guide you through a small presentation that we've prepared so that you know more about Canada.
Ma'am, today we are going to explore Canada, right?
Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, can I move to next slide?
Yeah, please.
Capital. Ma'am, Canada's capital is Ottawa, right?
Right. We'll just go through that again. I would request everyone to mute themselves till the presentation is going on. And once it is over, then we will have a discussion on whatever you have learned. Is it okay? Okay, so we know where it is located. You can see in the map.
Canada is near Arctic Circle.
Yes, yes. Please, everyone, I would request you to mute yourself. Let us first go through the presentation and then we will see. We will take up your questions later on. Okay. So we know Canada, as somebody mentioned, it is near the Arctic Circle and it is a country in North America. It has 10 provinces and 3 territories which extend from the Atlantic to the Pacific and northward into the Arctic Ocean, which covers 9.98 million square kilometers. And it is the world's second largest country by the total area. Its southern and western border with the United States stretches across 8,891 kilometers, which is the world's longest binational land border. And one interesting fact I want to tell you here is that Canada has the biggest coastline in the world. If you travel 20 kilometers, stroll along its coastline, it would take you 33 years to to cover all of that coastline. So it will take 33 years to cover the whole of the coastline of Canada. So can we move to the next slide, please? Nancy, next slide, please.
Maybe it's an internet issue. Wait. Just
no problem. Okay, we'll just speak. Somebody had mentioned earlier when we had started that there are many lakes in Canada. That's true. We have like lots and lots of lakes there. And at the last count, there may be as many as 2 million, with 563 of them larger than 100 square kilometers. And among the largest lakes are Lake Huron in Ontario. So Canada is also the country which has the largest lakes. And the oldest known rocks can also be found there. The Canadian Shield forms the U-shape extending from Lake Superior in the south to the Arctic Islands in the north. Okay, now coming back to this, you can see the different provinces in Canada. On the south side, you find the capital. Can you see the capital? Children, please mute yourself.
Ma'am, Canada is the land area.
Ma'am, it is Ottawa.
Yeah, we'll come to that. We'll come to that. You can go through this map first. Can you locate where is
Canada's capital is Ottawa?
Yeah, can you see it on the map where it is?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes.
Ma'am, to mark the capital, there is a star on presentation.
is a star.
Yes. Yes. And you can you tell me which is the largest, tallest mountain peak in Canada? Anyone knows the tallest mountain peak in Canada? Yeah, no, Nesa is raising her hand.
Yes. Yes, well, I wanted to tell.
Yeah.
The land area of Canada is 9.985 million
kilometers.
Yes, true.
Ma'am, the tallest peak is Mount Logan.
Yes, true. So Mount Logan in Yukon in Canada is the tallest mountain and its height is 5,995 meters. And it is found in the Clunie National Park and Reserve. And this mountain is named after Canadian geologist William Edmund Logan. And he's the founding member of the Geological Survey of Canada.
Ma'am, it's Mountain Logan.
Yeah.
Ma'am?
Yeah.
So Mount Logan is the world highest mountain, right?
Not the world highest. It's Canada's largest mountain.
So it is like Mount Everest kind of, right?
Do you know what is the height of Mount Everest?
No. 29,000.
Very big of very.
So you compare it. You search it and then you compare it with this mountain in Logan. Okay?
There is no mountain taller than Mount Everest.
Ma'am, okay. In Canada, they call it Canadian dollar or dollar?
It's Canadian dollar. And you know what? You can actually see through your currency. Do you know that? You can see through the currency in Canada because there is a plastic, transparent plastic. It is a plastic money currency is there. It's not paper. It is plastic money. And in like in the center, it is a transparent plastic and you can actually put it across and see through that currency. You can Google it up. And this is like, it is a plastic-like material which has a clear strip which runs through it. So it allows you to see from one side to the other. And this currency was introduced in order to create a durable alternative to our old paper bills. And the bills were built to withstand very high temperatures as well as those times where you inevitably leave a bill in your pocket and it goes through the washing machine. So Canadian currency is all plastic. It is a plastic-like material. Okay. And the national flag, many people mentioned, it has a maple leaf and it is referred to as the Canadian flag or unofficially the maple leaf. It consists of a red field with a white square at its center in the ratio of 1:2:1 in the middle.
Ma'am, can I take a screenshot?
Yeah, do take it. And it is an 11-pointed maple leaf which is charged in the center. It is the first flag to have been adopted by both houses of parliament and officially proclaimed by the Canadian monarch as the country's official national flag. And this flag became the predominant and most recognizable national symbol of Canada. Now we'll move on to a little bit of history about Canada. Okay? Nancy, please change the slide.
Just a minute, I'll share. Mom.
Please, ma'am, I'm Shrutish.
Yeah.
Yes.
Move on to the next slide, please. So when Europeans explored Canada, they found all regions occupied by native people and they called Indians because the first explorers thought they had reached the East Indies. And the native people lived off the land, some by hunting and gathering and others by raising the crops. Shruti, please go back. Go back. Yeah. And the Canada that we know today is relatively recent construction, which is less than 65 million years old, but it is composed of fragments of crust that are as old as 4 billion years. And do you know from where the name Canada came? The name Canada came from the word Kanata, which means a village or a settlement. In 1535, two Aboriginal youth told French explorer Jacques Cartier about the route to Kanata. They were actually referring to the village of Stadacana, the site of the present-day Quebec. And Canada became a country, the Dominion of Canada, in 1867. Before that, British North America was made up of a few provinces. The vast area of Rupert's Land, privately owned by Hudson Bay Company, and the Northwestern Territory. And do you know that 80% of Canada is in uninhabited? Why?
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Stopping short slide, which is constant on the right side. With writing.
Which one?
Yeah, when Europeans explored Canada. Is this there in your slide? Because we have this constant here.
Shruti, please look into this.
Because of that, the whole image is not visible on the PPT.
Okay, I think this is the slide number seven.
Okay, the image, it's written on the PPT only.
Yeah.
Ma'am, then the whole image of the what you're showing is not visible.
No, we are not showing image. You can just see the glimpse of Canada, and this is the information about Canada.
Yes,
ma'am. Ma'am, you can just...
Yeah.
Ma'am, your voice is breaking.
I think it's a network issue, maybe at your end.
Ma'am, you're audible.
Yeah,
because... Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Now you're audible.
Yeah. I was telling you that 80% of Canada is uninhabitable. Why? Because of its geography and climate, which is inhospitable to humans as you move up further to the north. And the bulk of the population lives in larger cities near the US border. Canada's only neighboring nation is US. And as you notice in the map, Canada's most livable span west to east. And this is where you will find...
Ma'am.
Yeah.
In Canada, we get world famous coffee.
Yes, we'll discuss about other things. Let me first go through the presentation. Kindly mute your microphones, please, for some time.
Ma'am?
Yeah.
You are showing in the picture that's a factory, ma'am.
Yeah, it's a factory. Let me just go through the presentation. I'm just telling you a few more things about Canada. We will take up all your comments and questions later on after the presentation is over. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Kindly mute yourselves. Yeah, Shruti. So now moving on, do you know when is the Canada Day? Shruti, move on to slide number 11.
I don't know.
Canada Day. Yeah. So Canada Day is celebrated
on 1st of July.
Yes, on 1st of July.
1st of July.
Yeah. And you already know the capital of Canada is Ottawa. Can we show the next slide, Shruti? That's the capital. And which is the largest state in Canada?
Toronto.
Largest state?
Toronto.
No, no.
Ontario.
No.
Nunavut.
So it is 2.093 million kilometers square area. And as you see, it is covered in snow most of the time. Okay. And which is the language which is used in Canada?
Yes.
French and English.
Yes, French and English. French and English. So according to the 2016 census, French. English and French are the mother tongue of 56% and 21.4% of Canadians. And in total, 86.2% of Canadians have working knowledge of English, and while 29.8% have working knowledge of French. Next slide, please.
Ma'am.
We'll take up the questions later on after the presentation, please. You can note down your points.
Ma'am, it's not a question. I have some problem.
Yeah, tell me.
I can't see anyone's camera.
Maybe because you need to check your settings. Check your settings or you log in again. That might solve your problem. Okay. Okay. So moving now to Canada's government. Next slide, Shruti. Canada is a parliamentary democracy. Its system of government holds that the law is the supreme authority. And the land of Canada is owned by Queen Elizabeth II, who is also the head of the state. And only 9.7% of the total land is privately owned, while the rest is crown land. The land is administered on behalf of the crown by various agencies or departments of the government of Canada. Who is the Prime Minister of Canada?
Ma'am, your voice is cracking.
Check your net connection.
Ma'am, Justin today.
Yes.
Yeah,
ma'am, you're audible. You're audible.
Yeah. So now we have the picture image of the Prime Minister of Canada with the Indian flag and the Canadian flag in the background. Okay, so coming now to the total population of Canada, somebody had mentioned in the beginning that the total population was around 38 million people.
3.76 crore.
So if you convert it into million, it is 38.27 million. And the currency of Canada?
Canadian dollar.
Yes, you can see some of the currency there.
Ma'am, I want to tell a fact about Canadian dollars.
Yeah, we'll discuss it after the presentation gets over, please. Okay. Yeah.
Ma'am, your voice is cracking.
Check your network.
Ma'am, my network is okay.
Okay, so which is the national sports of Canada?
Ma'am, we can hear
hockey
you
and ice hockey.
Ma'am. Please, if you are not able to hear me, you can log out and log in again. That may solve the problem. But keep your mics on mute, please. Oh, somebody has written hockey and ice hockey. No, it is not the national game. The game which is ice hockey is recognized as national winter sport of Canada, and the game which is commonly known as lacrosse is recognized and declared to be the national summer sport of Canada. So we have two different sports for summer and winter as the national sport of Canada.
Understand the name, ma'am. Sport name.
It is written on the screen. You can check it from there. Lacrosse. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Now, I got it.
Now coming to the climate. Climate in Canada, it can be extremely cold, and with summer which can last less than 2 months. But almost all Canadians live near the southern border where the weather is warmer. And the climate around Vancouver on Canada's west coast is rainy and temperate. And it rarely snows except in the mountains. Now coming now to the animals which one can find in Canada. Can you see some of the animals which can be found there? The grizzly bear, cougar, moose, gray wolf, giant Canadian goose, whales, marmot, wolverine, the American pika, and bison. Can you identify these animals?
Mama, know about yes. grizzly bear.
Yes, ma'am. I know all of these animals. Dolphins, okay. Whales.
Yes. So you can Google what other animals you can also find in Canada. Okay, so the more information if you want, there is a link in the next slide which you can go through and you'll get more information about Canada. You can watch the actually go on a virtual tour to Canada with this link.
Okay, ma'am.
So there is the airline industry. Somebody has mentioned Air Canada is the airline agency. It is a flag carrier and the largest airline of Canada by fleet size and passengers carried. It is headquartered in the borough of St. Laurent in Montreal, which is Quebec, and which is in Quebec.
Ma'am?
Yeah.
At Canada, it has 6 time zones.
Yes. Yes. So then now we have some more interesting facts for you. Would you want to hear them?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, can you share a fact about Canada?
Ma'am,
One second, children. Please do not speak over each other. Let one person finish, wait for their answer, and then go to your next question, okay? Do not talk at the same time, please. Otherwise, I'll not be able to answer anyone. So we can start with one person, raise your hand, and then ask your question so that others know that the one question is being answered at that point of time. Okay? So one by one. Yes?
Ma'am, what animal is marmot?
I didn't get that.
Which animal is marmot?
You need to find it out. Which animal is more?
Okay.
You also need to do some homework. Yeah.
How many states are there in Canada?
You tell me. Rudra is asking something. Yeah, Rudra.
Ma'am, I want to tell something.
Yeah, please tell, Rudra.
National animal of...
Yes.
National animal of Canada is beaver and national bird is grey jay.
Yes, very good. Very good.
Right.
Ma'am, Canada has the longest highway in the world.
Yes. It has the longest highway. And you know, there is a version of the Dead Sea also there in the Middle East, which is known as the Dead Sea, the sea in which you can never sink. And this is, there is kind of a small sea in Canada, which has a little Manitou Lake. And this is fed by underground springs, which is 13.3 square kilometer lake and has mineral salt concentrations of 180,000 mg per liter. Therefore, it is making it extremely buoyant. So nobody can sink in that sea.
Ma'am?
Yeah, just wait. Let me see. I am just, let me just look at the people who are raising their hands. Let me take it one by one.
Ma'am, somebody just asked the permission to me that somebody wants to control my camera.
Yes, it's not somebody, it is a host who's hosting this meeting would want to control your camera. Please allow those.
Ma'am, so please send me a request again. I will allow it. I had not quite wrote the name right. So.
Yeah, I'm seeing somebody has raised the hand, but I can only see a girl there with written iPad. Probably she's eating something in the red top. Yeah.
Ma'am, Canada has 20%. Ma'am, Canada has 20% of world's fresh water.
Yes. Yes, please wait. I have asked somebody to already who has raised a hand. Yeah, iPad. I can only see that with the red top. Yeah, tell me.
Ma'am, I can't hear you.
You log out and log in again, then maybe you'll be able to hear me. Okay.
Ma'am, I want to tell a fact about Canadian dollars.
Yeah, what's your name?
Rudra.
Yes, Rudra.
Canadian dollars has two marks.
Okay.
First, that is a S and line middle.
Let me just check. Ayush wants to ask something. Ayush, are you there?
Ma'am, it was very interesting fact.
Yeah. So where is Ayush? Ayush raised his hand.
Ma'am, I can't hear you.
You need to log in again. Nesa Joshi raised her
hand. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, tell me.
Ma'am, near Niagara Falls, there is a bridge. So there are cars and everything. So we need to cross and we need to do the immigration. And
ma'am, I'm here, ma'am.
And in the hotel, we need to sit and drink the coffee.
Ma'am, yeah. You are the host, Natha. Please send me the request to control my camera, please.
Shruti, please see. And you know, one yes. more interesting fact I want to tell you all is that in Canada, Santa Claus actually replies to the children. When you write a letter to Santa, you get a reply back. Do you know that?
So magical.
Yes, it's kind of magical.
Yes, ma'am, it's so magical.
Yeah.
Ma'am, how?
I want to go to Canada. This is the best day of my life.
So, ma'am, when you write to Santa, you'll receive your reply back.
Ma'am, but in India, ma'am, in India, why that does not happen?
In India, did you try writing?
Yes, ma'am.
Where did you post it?
Yes, please, and I got my reply back also.
Okay. Good.
Ma'am, how does this happen?
This happens through a post office, which is it is known as the Canada Post Volunteers, who take a letter, who collect all these letters and actually reply back in many languages. In more than 30 languages, they've actually replied to the children.
Ma'am, I have two questions, ma'am.
Yeah.
Does Canada have a version of Dead Sea?
Yes.
Okay.
Huh?
And 6 Canadian?
Yeah.
Million resident in... One second, ma'am.
Ma'am?
Let him finish first.
Okay.
No, ma'am. Ma'am, I'm done, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, doubt.
what is the national fish of Canada?
National what?
Fish.
I'm not able to hear you properly.
What is the national fish of Canada?
I didn't get you, please. Can you put it in the chat box?
He's telling fish.
National fish.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't know. You find it out.
Okay, ma'am.
I want to tell you about a very different sport which is there in Canada. There is an annual bathtub race. Do you know that? There's an annual bathtub race in Canada. And this dates back to 1667 BC.
Ma'am?
And this,
I want to say something.
Everyone is speaking at the same time. I'm not able to hear anyone. Please speak one by one only.
Ma'am, Kiona is...
Ma'am, voice is breaking.
So you need to log out and log in again because I think everyone, to others, I'm quite audible.
Ma'am?
You're audible.
Yeah.
Ma'am, sorry.
Ma'am, you're audible, but little disturbance, ma'am, that's all.
Maybe because of your network or maybe the other people. One request to everyone, kindly mute yourself. Only the person who's speaking needs to unmute. Is that clear?
Ma'am, Kiona is speaking.
Yeah.
So, can you tell me the address?
Address of what?
Santa Claus.
Children in Canada, they write to Santa Claus. And let me just tell you one second. They just write Santa Claus, North Circle, North Pole, something like that, Canada.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, kids think that...
There's a North Pole.
North Pole, yeah.
Ma'am, kids think that there is a gift factory of Santa in North Pole.
Yes.
In border of North Pole somewhere.
Yeah.
North Pole is fully winter, ma'am. There'll be a lot of snow there.
Yes. Ma'am, guess. So we have a small
video
for everyone.
People often go there and visit.
Okay, everyone wants to visit Canada and wants to see the video. Then everyone on mute and I'll show you a small video where you can see the whole Canada, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Ma'am, Canada literacy is 99.9%. So almost all Canadians can read and write.
Ma'am, your screen is not visible.
Ma'am?
Is it visible now?
Yes, ma'am.
For travelers to explore. Traveling through Canada affords visitors various opportunities to enjoy culture, nature, adventure, sightseeing, and all kinds of activities. As tourists traverse the country, we'll find incredibly diverse landscapes, a mix of cultural influences, unique cities, and interesting attractions. Western Canada, with cities like Vancouver and Calgary, is well known for the beautiful scenery of the Rocky Mountains. Vancouver Island, off the west coast, is home to the British Columbia capital city of Victoria, along with old growth forests, beaches, and rugged coastal scenery. Central Canada is home to the prairies, and further east, forests and lakes, including the Great Lakes. At the heart of the country is the city of Toronto, Canada's biggest city, and nearby, the capital city of Ottawa. Heading still further east is the French-speaking province of Quebec. While much of the nation is of British and French descent, Canada is home to a mosaic of multicultural communities. This video is an overview of the 10 best places to visit in Canada. If you are are still not subscribed yet to my channel, please remember to subscribe now. Calgary is situated between the Canadian Prairies and the foothills of the Canadian Rockies. Calgary is a great city for a budget traveler, with its large selection of free and low-cost activities. The Calgary Stampede is undoubtedly Calgary's best-known visitor attraction. This event, featuring a large parade and world-class rodeo, draws more than 1 million people each year. Canada Olympic Park is a multi-purpose athletic facility designed for skiing, snowboarding, bobsleigh, and luge during the winter and mountain biking during the summer. Other attractions, including Calgary Tower and Eau Claire Market, are other great places to visit year-round.
Are you often confused between two answer choices while solving sentence connection?
Ottawa, Canada's capital, in the east of southern Ontario, near the city of Montreal and the US border. As the nation's capital, Ottawa is home to many financial, commercial, and federal establishments, including Parliament Hill. Running right through the heart of the city, the Rideau Canal is Ottawa's star attraction. In winter, the canal becomes the world's largest ice skating rink. Parks, gardens, and wide, open public spaces pay an accessible and year-round homage to all four seasons. Average temperatures are well below 0 degrees Celsius from December to March, but locals celebrate the city's longest seeming season with a bunch of outdoor pursuits. As spring clicks to summer, auspicious tulips cheer the downtown, followed by vibrant fall leaves that line the streets with eye-popping reds and yellows. Whistler, located in the spectacular coast mountains of British Columbia, just 2 hours north of Vancouver, Whistler is Canada's favorite year-round destination. There's two majestic mountains, with a vibrant base village, epic skiing and snowboarding, four championship golf courses, unbeatable shopping, restaurants and bars. At the base of the two mountains are three quaint villages, Whistler Village, Creekside, and Upper Village. This gabled alpine village and 2010 Olympics venue is one of the world's most popular ski resorts. Before the skiers and boarders came, Whistler was a logging town with the name Alter Lake, which was well known for its snow. Not surprisingly for a ski resort, Whistler gets its fair share of snow and cold weather. Typical winter temperatures average about 0 degrees Celsius during the day and minus 6 degrees Celsius overnight in the village.
Writing's not that easy, but Grammarly can help. This sentence is grammatically correct.
Vancouver Island. Named after the British explorer George Vancouver, is the largest island off the west coast of the North American continent, the largest populated landmass between Western North America and New Zealand, around 500 kilometers long and 100 kilometers wide. Vancouver Island is studded with colorful, quirky communities. Vancouver Island is a top global destination for raw, untouched nature and wildlife. The landscape is one of mountains, lakes, rainforest, and rugged coastline, dotted with small towns and villages. In the south is Victoria, the picturesque capital city of British Columbia. Further north, particularly on the west side of the island, are some lovely natural areas with great hiking, including the famous West Coast Trail. Quebec City. One of the most beautiful cities in North America, Quebec City.
That's the video is cracking.
The hilltop French-speaking city has a
cracking.
Ma'am, it's clear.
Ma'am, it is clear.
Strong defensive position, set on a rocky spur, with 100-meter cliffs, and protected on two sides by rivers. As the capital of Quebec province, Quebec City is an important commercial center, but it hasn't lost sight of the past. With its narrow streets, walled fortifications, and centuries-old buildings, Quebec is a designated UNESCO World Heritage Site. The city's icon, the stunning Chateau Frontenac, is regarded as the most photographed hotel in North America and offers tours even without an overnight stay. Toronto. The capital of Ontario, Toronto is the most populated city in Canada, as well as one of the largest cities in North America. With a large number of ethnic districts, like Chinatown, Little India, and Little Italy, Toronto is also one of the world's most culturally diverse cities. The city's main tourist draws range from impressive landmarks, such as the iconic CN Tower and the fairy tale castle of Casa Loma. Additionally, the Toronto Islands are a popular destination with beaches and outdoor activities. Montreal. The second largest city in Canada after Toronto, Montreal is the cultural and financial capital of the Quebec province. Boasting the largest French-speaking community outside of Paris, France, Montreal is a bustling metropolis, comprised of a downtown district, a historic quarter, entertainment district, and several distinctive neighborhoods. Montreal's main sites include downtown skyscrapers, like